हेलो, वेरी गुड। हेलो, या ओके, या हेलो। कैन यू ऑल हियर मी?
यस सर।
यस सर।
ओके, गुड गुड। अच्छा मृणालिनी, योर थिंग विच यू वर आस्किंग, आई विल वील अटेंड टू दैट ऑल्सो टूडे। द रीजन वाई यू कुंट सी द फाइल वॉज बिकॉज this was a data cube bits file. Anyway, I'll explain as we proceed today. Okay. Shall we wait a little more for others to join in? Okay. Okay, so how are things with all of you? Could you get the IRF running in your systems?
Yes, sir. I could run IRF, and I'm trying to kind of like introduce myself to the whole thing, incorporating it with DS9 and GalFit. So I'm playing around the data, sir.
Okay, so I'll show you a little bit of IRF, okay, so that you know how you'll have, so that you can build over that, okay? Because initially IRF can be very tricky and it small things can also create problems. So I will give you a short introduction to this IRF, and then we will, you'll be able to proceed ahead. Okay, so shall we wait for others to come in? So this was Satyaki, no? Satyaki Goswami?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, so you have IRF running, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And did you try opening images and FITS files and other things?
Sir, actually, prior to this project, sir, like I have some experience with IRF. For my master's thesis, sir, I was using IRF for data analysis, sir.
Okay, good.
So, sir, but now I have been, for the last few months, I have been out of touch with IRF. So again, I'm trying to, you know, sir, like get myself used to it. So
okay, fine. Okay, good. But because, you know, what happens for the people who have just started with it, there are simple nuances which you need to know, like you have to start the exit term and only from there you start IRF, whether it's CL. Many a times people want to invoke IRF by writing IRF or so, but it doesn't work. So CL, command language, is what you have to type. Okay, so we will start off, and I will, what about Arif?
Yes, sir.
Do you have IRF running?
No, sir. I am just, I am trying to, I am having kind of trouble with NR. So,
are you using Ubuntu?
Yes, sir.
So today I downloaded it and installed it and I tried it on two systems and it has worked well. It has installed. So if you can follow those instructions which I sent, if you have Anaconda running, then you go from the stage beyond the Anaconda where you are downloading that Miniconda line is there, right? In that script, which
I think I had problems with Galfit also. Libraries were not present in that. So I think I will figure it out shortly. I mean, right now I will figure it out just now.
Okay. Mridalini, what about you?
Sir, I tried this in the terminal and I'm getting this error. Unable to create new file, permission denied.
So you run it with sudo command, sudo. You are in...
Yes, sir. I entered it using sudo and logged in inside. And then I ran the command that the dpkg first line. And then I got...
No, forget about that dpk, that thing. You go to the stage. You have Anaconda running?
Yes, sir.
So you forget those first few lines. I will just read out.
Okay, sir.
See, just a minute. Where is this?
Sir, and I have installed Anaconda yesterday, and it is running only inside the Anaconda 3 directory in the bin directory. Outside that, it is not running.
See, there is one conda config dash dash add channels.
Yes, sir.
HTTP. From there you run.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then you run this conda create minus n IRF 27 Python equal to 2.7, that one. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, and then it should be from there onwards. So the second line will take a long time to install. Conda create minus an IRF. Okay.
Okay,
that
sir.
Will take a long time to download a lot of things and run. Okay. And then sudo apt-get install sao ds9. I think ds9 is working for most of you.
Yes, sir, ds9 is working.
Yeah. So if you do that, then things will be fine. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So then what you have to do, I'll just open a, I'll share my screen. Just a minute. Yeah, so you can see this, right? All of you can see. Yeah. So best thing is to you make directory, and let me call it work session. Okay, some name I'm giving. Okay. And I will go into this work area. Just call it some work directory where you are going to do your IRAP things. Okay. And see, it's now in empty location. Okay. So now you have to type conda, like I've written in that conda activate. And IRAF 27. Yes, so conda activate IRAF 2.27. Okay. And now if I run the command ds9 and ampersand, then it will open the ds9. You may not be seeing it now, but I'll show it later. Okay, then ds9 window has opened up. Okay. Another thing which you do, yeah. So in fact, before we do that, before starting DS9, when you, this was just to check whether things are working fine. So after you do conda activate IRF 27, you run the command make IRF. Okay. So if we don't activate that, then it doesn't know where all these things are sitting. And if you run this make IRAF, then it creates some user parameter directory, and it creates a login file in which it keeps some basic information how to start the IRAF terminal. And so here you say XG term. It asks you what kind of a enter terminal type. See, it's saying enter terminal type, and I'm specifying it to be exit term. And now you look at in this directory, you have one login.cl, and you have users parameters. UPARM is a directory. So I can go into this directory and say UPARM. And there, as of now, it is empty. But as the users, as we are setting up parameters for different tasks, it gets saved here. Okay, we'll come to that later. Similarly, you can see this login.cl file. And as you know, Linux is what, case sensitive. That's why you can't put capital L login.cl. So this login.cl has certain things which are here. Okay. Somehow the whole thing is not showing up, I think. But set home as /home. I'm running it on Priyamam's thing. That's why home, see, work session was the directory I created. So it is setting home for that as a the same location. And image directory as /temp priya and cache in whatever directory, and so on and so forth. Okay, user ID And as you go further in working, you will see how to use this. See, similarly, you have many of these set editor as VI, set printer as LP, set, right? So if you want to remove this comment, you can remove it. And then when you run VI from your Linux, sorry, from your IRF prompt, it will open the VI editor. Okay. So as of now, don't bother too much about this. A little later, we will look into this, right? So important thing is you run the conda activate IRF 27. For the installation which I sent you, for the instructions I sent you today, if you have installed it in some other way and it is finding the path from anywhere, then you don't have to do this conda activate IRF. Okay. So now I start the XG term. Okay, I'll tell you what happens if we don't. So basically, starting with IRF is you have to put CL, command language, and this goes into the this is the IRF environment, and you see a lot of packages in that. Yeah, ADCCDROM, DBMS, there are so many, plot, STSDS, and so on. There are various packages, and if we get into them, for example, images is one. If I say image, I needn't write the whole thing. If I can even put a few words, which will identify one from the other, like there are many with M's. If I just put an M, it's not sufficient, but if I had put ME, then it would have gone into MEM0. MSCD, it would have gone with MSCDB, right? Anyway, so inside this package images, there are many tasks, M-cords, M-filter, M-fit, M, right? These are all different tasks. If you want to come out of the package, you say by, B, you needn't write the whole of by, but if you just say B by also, it jumps out of it. Okay. For example, I can go to tables, right? And in this, there are table plot and various things. TT tools. Right, so TT tools, and TT tools has some more things sitting inside. So if I say buy, it will come out of that. Another buy will get me out of this. And if I say LO, log out, then I come out of IRF. So getting into CL, IRF is CL, and LO is to come out of it. So if I say SL, and there is a tool called you can see images. For example, I say display. There's a task called display, and I ask to show a certain image. Okay. Now, when I run this file, this thing, there is one sample files which sits into IRF. Basically, for us to check whether everything is working fine. And that file is called dev.pix. That's the name of the file, dev.pix. And see, it will not run. It will not run because I have not opened the DS9. So I'm just trying to say dev.pix, and it says cannot open device. Okay. So technically, before starting our IRF, we should have started DS9. Okay. But suppose you have not done it, you can put exclamation mark and say DS9 here. So when you put exclamation mark and all, then it will run the all the commands of of IRA of Linux. Okay, so exclamation mark DS9, and I'll put an ampersand. Why do I put an ampersand? Because then it will run it in the background. So now I will have to work in. I'll have to reshare the screen. Stop share, and I will share. So it has opened this thing, right? And now when I run that same command which I had done, display, and say dev dollar pix, and I say in the first buffer it has opened up this Whirlpool Galaxy image, which is a stored one. Okay, so now you can do various things in that. You can zoom, make it smaller, make it still smaller, bigger, whatever. You can view it. You can look at this in different colors, grayscale, A, B. These are different filters in which you can see. And when you are looking at it in different filters, you can see certain features which are otherwise hidden. So these are just filters which are accentuating certain regions more or less. Okay, so these are the things. And suppose we want to add one more frame into this, and I can say frame and say new frame, and in this I can add another image if I want. Okay, so I'll stop share this one, and I'll go back and share my terminal. Okay, so this was one thing. Another thing is there is a command called contour. So I'll say contour, and for the same image, if I do contour, you will see that a lot of junk will appear on the screen. And the reason is we have seen that it's showing all this nonsense. Okay, so what we should have done is we should have started. We should have started our IRAF. We should have started an IRAF through XG term. So everything will work if you just run it through that terminal too. But so XG term, okay. And once I start this XG term, where is that XG term? Wait. Yeah, so I exit term. Wait a minute. Now it's not showing the exit term. Yeah, so I think this is a better way of doing that. Yeah, so now I needn't keep switching from one to the other. Yeah, so see, it has started this XG term, and in the XG term, from here I invoke my IRAF. So now when I do a CL, it is not working. So you again have to do a Anaconda activate this IRF 27. Okay, and now when I do a CL, it should work fine. Okay, and now when I do a contour of this dev dollar pix, I will see that you will get the contour map of the whole thing. Okay. So similarly, what I'll do is I'll copy. Okay, so these graphics which we are getting here will be possible only if you invoke IRF from the XG terminal. X terminal handles only text, XG handles even graphics. And there are various things to that. So as we get into IRF, there is much we can do. But for this project, we don't have to learn much of IRF other than certain things. Okay, so now, right, so what I will do is hello, and I will copy the files. Copy files which are there in some other directory. Some of the image files which are there, I've got them here. Yeah. So I have got these. Yes. Okay. So now I will start this. So now when I say display, and we had this image dot fits. I open it into the first frame. Okay, this was the one which we had, and I'll open the other file with what was that? one.out.fits, which we had in the frame 2. Okay, so now you can see that this, what you are seeing now is the Galfit image which we created. And this one is the actual image we started off with, one img.fits. And this was the model which it fit. So like we saw yesterday, we can do this blinking also, okay? Or you can tile them up together. And you can see it in all kinds of colors. I can zoom out. Similarly, I'll zoom out. Okay. So now what I will do is this. There is something called, okay. So this task which we use, the command display which we used, right? There is something called epar, edit parameters for a certain task. If I say epar display, and it opens up, one is lpar, which will list the parameters. One is epar, which allows us to edit the parameters. So here I have image name, yeah? So right here I can change. You can see that it says one out.fits, okay? Because the first one which I did, the second time I ran, I gave it with the parameter one out.fits. Now here if I say this dev dollar pix, okay, and down arrow, frame number 3 down arrow, and this way we can go. And finally, I say colon, and say go. You can keep changing all parameters as and when you like, but when I say this, it opens up in the third one, right? So this is called edit parameters. Okay, So now I will, there is a task called, you can do arithmetic with these frames. We have already discussed regarding this earlier. You can add, subtract, and do various things. So there is this E par and im arith. Oh, two T's have come. Im arith. If I say E par im arith, it gives me an operand one where I say one image dot. I've already run it once to check before we started. So you write the name of the file, im1img.fits, and down arrow, operand is plus or minus whatever. So we are writing minus, just subtracting, and operand two is one out.fits, right? And output file name, result, it says, I will call it sub.fits. Yeah, subtracted image. And then all these things I will not change. And I will just say go, colon go. So the moment I do that, you can see that it has created one more file called sub.fits. So I can display, this is a subtracted image of, yeah, fits in the third frame. I will remove this what happened, sub dot fits display sub dot. Yeah, I'll tell you what has happened. Okay, so now we have these three ones, and I go into the single one mode, and now if I blink this, see. Okay, so this is the original image. This is the model image, and this is the residual image. You see that? This is the original one, and this is the residual. Now, these features, these blobs and things which are, we can see here, could not be seen in the original one, right? So we are subtracting from the first one, I am subtracting the model, and this is the residue which you are getting. Okay, so you can do this kind of arithmetic with this, and we needn't have gone through EPAR and done it. We could have even used, we could have also done this as im arith, and one img, dot fits minus one out dot fits, and the subtract, I'll take the sub dot fits. Okay, so this way also you could have done it, and it should create a sub this. It's giving some error. Let me see what is the problem, and then let's display. Merit is right.
Sir, you have written sub to FIDS.
Huh?
Sub to FITS.
Yeah. Sub 2.FITS. Anyway, so Acha, while we are at this, there was an image which Mrinalini had sent. She downloaded an image which I have got it here, and you will see that that image is m59.fits, m85.fits and m59.fits. These are two images, FITS files, which Mrinalini downloaded, and she was having trouble, right? So if I try to say run the command display and I say m59.fits and I put it in whichever frame, it is giving an error. It says fxf must specify which FITS extension, right? Which FITS extension we are looking for. So Mrinalini, the thing is, these FITS files nowadays, what they are doing is they are making data cubes. There are many layers to the FITS file. So the same thing, if you say square brackets and put say one, okay, and I do it, and here you will get it, right? So you look at it, display FITS, I can take the 0, 1, and it has say image has no pixels. It is not showing any pixels, okay. The second slice, it has the image. This is the science image, right? If you take the second one, you are getting some, very faintly you are getting some sigma image, right? This is the sigma image, and so on and so forth. So the reason was, it was saying which, it was asking which slice, which extension should it fit. So these FITS files have different, it's a data cube, okay? And hence you have to specify which one it is.
So, it's not advisable to get a drizzled image to do this kind of work?
The drizzled image is there in one of the, I think second one or third one is the drizzled image, I think. Third one is drizzled image, displays.
I downloaded as a drizzled image.
So you can, and then you can do the imhead. You can see the imhead of that file. And sorry, I shouldn't have put this thing. So if I say imhead, then it shows what those things are. Imhead one, right? It is a 1241x1146 FITS file. It's real. The entries are real. Basically, what it is showing, it's an array of 1241x1146, and the entries, they are real. These are basically pixels which have the charges in it, and the values are real numbers. Okay. So to understand what the header is, I think you have to go to tables, and in tables there's one cat file m59.fits. No, where is it? TT tools. Let me see. FITS file. Wait. It is not there in tables. Wait. It is in STSDS Fits.io. In this, there is this cat fits. Yeah, cat fits. Cat fits, and I say when I say m59.fits. So see, it is showing for this file that the 0th one is mfits file drizzle j96d103drz.fits. One is image, it's a science image. Yeah, and it's giving the size. The second is image WHT. Third is image CTX. Right? So it is giving what these things are. Okay. So right. So you get into STSDAS, fits input output. In that there is this cat fits, which catenates, it shows what are the different slices in that. How many are there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things are there. The first one is the drizzle, one is the sigma image and other things. So when you see these, you will get to know. And coming out of it is you say bye, and here you are. Okay. So what happens is they drizzle, when they are taking the image, they do the drizzling and get it. Okay, so there are various tools, various things that you can do, imexamine and analyze the file and other things. Okay, so...
Sir, now is there any need to separate only this first frame from the...
Correct. You have to do that. Good thing. Good thing you asked. So what you will have to do is, there is im copy. I say im copy and I want the science image. So we have seen by cat's fits that for m59 dot fits, that bracket one, this was the science one. So I im copy only the seconds, not the zero, but the oneth one. And I want to save it as some other, say M59, and I call it science. Yeah, SC science image, suppose I call it. Dot fits. So once I do that, it has created a file. You can see that we have a m59 sc image dot fits, right? And now I can do a display of this m59 science image dot fits. And there it is. Okay. And then you use this one for your Galfit. You understand? Because I don't know whether Galfit can use the slices. I don't think it may. You can try even there that you are trying Galfit on m59.fits square brackets one, but I doubt it will happen. So it's better to come into IRF and take this and save it as a separate file. Now this doesn't have the other things, right? So imhead, you can now imhead and look at m59.fits and you'll get the header information, what it is. Either I put a slice here or I say science image. What happened? M8 M59 science image.
Sir, actually you named it M95.
Oh God, yeah. M95 I named it.
And yes, 90. Sir.
Okay, God, yeah, yeah. Yeah, thank you, thank you. I would have been going around in circles. M95 science image dot fits, and it'll give you the header information. What are the, what is the size and so on. And yeah, so even the other thing which we were talking about, if you have the whole Virgo field or so, and there are many galaxies there, or you have two galaxies sitting in the same frame, I just want to cut out a small stamp of it. So again, you use this imcopy and you specify X colon from which X ranges from what to what and Y should range from what to what. And you can save it as a separate file. And then you can do the gal fitting on, only on that stamp one. So that's why I was a bit keen to get this IRF going. All this can also be done by in AstroPy too. AstroPy, and that's the reason why people have abandoned IRF. But IRF is a very, very rich tool for various things in astronomy. For many years, people have developed it, and you can do photometry, you can do spectroscopy here, you can do all this arithmetic, you can do various things, imexamine, right? So you also have these imexamine and M95 science image dot fits. And when you go into imexamine, you see that cursor changes to this thing, and you can get it to any point. If there are any stars or objects, you get it there and press A, and you get objects sitting there or not. What is the pixel value? What is the sky value? Right? You can see, no? So there are a lot of things which can be done in IRF, which are extremely useful.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, you put an L, so the whole line is giving the light profile along that line. Similarly, you can do along a column, right? So you can analyze the whole thing extremely well. Yeah, somebody was asking.
Hello, sir. I'm Chiranjeev, sir. Sir, actually, I have downloaded the IRF from the Ubuntu App Store. And actually, I was trying to do the same stuff what you were doing here along with you. But there was I was getting some error at some point. And
can you just repeat in a moment? There's a mosque nearby, and those people have put a very, very loud speaker, even though I've shut down the windows.
Yeah, that's fine, sir.
Just 2 minutes we will wait. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, I also noticed that in. We'll just wait for a minute, okay?
Yes, sir.
In 2 minutes, it'll get over. Yeah, you can ask. So yes, you have installed it from the Ubuntu software.
Yes, sir. When I open the terminal, it directly opens that with that ECL in the beginning, like with
okay.
So when I try to run the DS9, it run properly. I mean, the DS9 open from inside that with that explanation in the beginning. But when I after try to open any image file, like any FITS file, like open that thing, I am unable to do from there. Like it says cannot open the image, cannot.
I'll make you a co-host so that you can share your screen.
Yes,
and
sir.
Run it and let us see what is happening. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. So one thing I told you, like the graphics will come only if you go into the exit term. Is your exit term opening?
No, sir. It's not open.
So you'll have to probably install that exit term also.
Okay.
Yeah. Otherwise, the display will work. So now you start your IRAP. Yeah, you.
Yeah, I'm showing, sir.
Yeah.
So is my screen visible?
Yeah, but it's a there's a black screen.
Yes. It's running actually.
No, you do one thing. When you are sharing screen, you go into share screen, and there is an advanced option. Take the advanced option, and in that you look for a portion of the screen. Yes, now it is fine.
Currently, it is visible, sir.
Yeah, now it's fine.
Actually, it was processing, sir. I mean, sharing was in process.
Okay.
So that's why.
Yeah.
So actually, I'm running the Ubuntu inside a virtual box, sir. So that's why it's a bit slow.
You are in Windows. You are running this within Windows.
Yes, sir. I mean, it's inside a virtual box, sir.
Oh God! Yeah, it slows down the machine tremendously.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay.
Sir, actually, I'm inside here. Actually, I'm unable to get out from this. Can you please tell me?
Okay. Put colon, colon,
yes,
go, geo. One way is you say colon, quit, Q,
okay.
It'll quit. Or else you say colon, write and quit. Move it down. No, not there. Get it down. Get your cursor down totally. Down arrow. You move.
It's not coming.
Don't change those parameters. Because then the whole, yeah, just use your down arrow.
No, sir, if I use the down arrow, it shows the previous commands actually.
Okay, you do it, still continue.
No, it's not working.
So should he first press to come to
enter that, let that junk come there, let it come down.
Okay, if we enter, it is coming down, sir.
Correct. Now say colon.
Yeah.
Okay. Further down.
Yes, sir. And colon and Q.
You quit without saving. Yeah. Quit. Q. Do a Q. It's come out. Okay. But now you will have to unlearn. Run a command called unlearn. Unlearn.
Yes.
Whatever task you were running, no? It was display.
Yes, sir. Unlearn display. Yes.
Otherwise, it will remember that junk values which have gone there. So whenever you, right? So now it is free and clean. So otherwise, that display will always create trouble for you. Yeah. So now you can again try that EPAR. And this time you run it carefully and it will be
still here, sir. This line thing is still here, sir.
Just press another enter.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, so I think that is gone. Now you, what were you trying to do? Which did work display? DS9 is open?
Yes, sir. I can open DS9, like if I press DS. 9.
Exclamation DS9 and ampersand.
Yes. It opens a DS9. Now it's not opening, but at that time it was. It opened.
Yeah. Now go back to your prompt. Uh-huh. Don't reduce that. Don't. Because when it appears, you will not see. Now click that window, that dark window. There you can say, give the command display, whatever.
Yes, sir.
Display.
So I'm in. I have these files. So let's. If I a display. So do I need to put explanation from the beginning?
No explanation now. If you are running Linux commands, then you'll have to put exclamation. Okay. But if these are IRF commands, you should not put an exclamation. Display, yes, gap, one space,
yes,
and that image file name, img.fits. And either you can press enter now or you can put one. If you just press enter now, it will ask you which frame. But if you already specify one,
yes,
then you can put one and put enter.
So now it's opening, sir.
Yeah, it opened.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Actually, that time I didn't press one. I directly tried to press enter after dot fits. That's why it was not working, I guess. Sir, XG term was also not working, sir.
XG. Now if you run the contour command, no? Contour. C-O-N-T-O-U-R.
Yes.
Contour. And give that same image name. It will give you junk here. IMG dot fits. It will show you a lot of junk on your screen. I didn't know it's come. So your XG term is running, that means. Very good. Yeah. Yeah, so it's giving the contour plot of that thing. Yeah?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so all's fine. All's fine. Good. So you just installed it directly from Ubuntu?
Yes, sir, from Ubuntu App Store.
Achas. I have Mint here.
Yes, yes.
I mean, I'm experimenting with Mint in the last few months.
Okay.
And in Mint, when I tried to install from there, it did something, but most of these things were not working. Libraries were not in place. Things were not there. So I think a proper Ubuntu distro will be a good one. Which Ubuntu? It's 20.04.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Good, good. So this is good for others too. They can... you can explain to them. See, there is an A there, which is for the packages. Yeah, you tell them how you did it.
Okay.
So if somebody is having issues, you can speak to...
So by going here, you can search in the search bar for...
IRF, okay. And then you...
Yeah, it will show this thing. As I have already installed, so it's showing remove. Otherwise, it will show to install.
Correct. Yeah. So it installs everything. Xterm, all. Very good. Very good. Yeah, I think that.
Sir, actually, in the latest model, the IRF is already installed. I mean, it gives you like the default applications.
Oh, very good. Yeah, I think that's the reason. Otherwise, in earlier times, we used to get a tarball. All kinds of tarballs from the NO AO side. One was for STDS tables, one for, one was basic IRF. Download it, unzip it, then install it. So maybe because it has been streamlined like this, that's why all those sites they don't have those tarballs anymore. Okay, good. So maybe we should leave Mint and go into Ubuntu. Then things will be working fine. In fact, I am going through a very bad period with my computer. Since 93, I had been just using Linux. And then recently, I bought a machine, computer, on which they forced me to buy Windows. And I have paid so much for Windows and Office and antivirus that I'm scared of throwing it out and installing Linux. And Windows is a big handicap. So that's why I have to use PMM's one or my very old machine. Yeah, so good. So this is... another thing which I would want you to see is this. let's go back to so now we had done this so with if you install IRF through Ubuntu, then we won't have to do that conda activate nonsense. And there is, instead of saying invoking IRF, you can try this pyref. Okay. And pyref makes things life even more easier. Okay. And you have this pyref thing, and you can run all these commands as we have done. You do pyref, and then even Python code and other things can also be used within this IRF. So you can, in this there are many other features. Otherwise, in that IRF, if you do back arrow and it works in a very strange way, here it'll be fine. Up arrow, down arrow, back arrow, all these things will work in pyref. And other than that, it will also, you'll be able to run, Python scripts and other things in it. Okay, so I think for today we have done. There's something specific you want to ask, you can ask me. Otherwise, we can meet whenever you want to meet again. When do you want to meet again? So the homework for you all is, you get IRF running, get used to it. There are documents on the net from which you can try and run things. There are exercises of IRF which you can try. Various things like EPAR and learn, unlearn, and LPAR, various things which you can do. Then you can do a lot of curve fitting and various things in IRF. So it's a very versatile, very useful package. And the things which we require from IRF for this project is basically, one, doing arithmetic with images, imarith, which we saw how we can subtract. So we have one image, and you have, so one thing is, if you are getting a fits which is in a cube, then you'll have to take a slice of that. All the present images, the new images which you have, it comes, the data is tremendous. That's why they are keeping it in data cubes. And to pull out the science image, you have to use, you can use AstroPy also, but IRF makes it very simple. So you can just pull out, and with imcopy, you saw how we can pull out that slice which has the science image. And then you can do a galfit on that. What Mrinalini probably was trying to do was doing it on the whole of the fits file, and it was, galfit was unable to do it. Secondly, once you have fit a model in that, then you can subtract the two to get the residue, right? Which shows you the morphology. Another thing which we shall do in the next classes, we'll do something on the source extractor. Right, so you can, as a prelude, you can go and look for source extractor astronomy, SC extractor it is called, and from an image file, source extractor picks up elements and shows which ones are stars, what are extended bodies, what are, right? So it extracts sources, and from there you can get the PSF file which we are using here. And you can get the sky, you can get various things from that. Or even from IRF, you can see the sky, right? We saw that when I did the image examined, and you move your cursor at a certain point where there's a dark sky, at any point you can put, and when you press A, it gives you details and it gives you what is the sky also. So that sky value goes into your Galfit FeedMe file, and the parameters also, which we actually get for objects, the minor major axis ratio and inclination, all those comes from the source extractor gives. And from that you take it, put it in the FeedMe file, and then you run it, right? And then we know how to get an output image, not to get an output image, and various things, right? So next session we can have it, say sometime in the mid week. By this time you have to get used to a little bit of IRAP, get it running, get used to it. And if there are issues, you can put it in our group. Some of you can answer them, or I can answer, and we'll proceed ahead. Okay. Today there are very few people.
Sir, I have a few questions.
Yes.
Sir, one thing is, when I did that in Galfit, I have given the name of the file, and within the square bracket I have given one, and Galfit started running with that frame only, and it was not giving the previous error. It ran like the one IMG file. It was running like that. It was doing the iterations and all. And then at the end, I have got an error called numerical recipes runtime error, singular matrix 2 now exiting the system. So it came out like that.
Okay. Achha, now you would use this imcopy, take a slice the way I did, and see whether you, when you run it with that, whether the same thing will happen or not. Okay. Because I didn't myself try. But if you put a square bracket one in, it ran. It's pretty good. But I'll see what the error is. I'll run it with my system and I'll see.
Okay.
Whether I'm getting the same thing or not.
Okay. Numerical recipes runtime error. And
okay. I'll have a look.
In the earlier versions, before Ubuntu 20, in Ubuntu Software Center, IRAF is not available. So I have to do it through terminal only. So it's still running.
Okay, very good. Okay, fine. I'll check it out.
And one more thing, sir. This image which we are extracting from this drizzled FITS file, we are copying the only the first frame. So from the header information of that file, how can we understand whether it is processed image or it is the raw image?
The ones which are given out in the on the archive, they are processed ones. Because, they are pre-processed images, because we will not be able to process it ourselves, because there are many things which you require. So you take them as processed and do it. You treat them as processed images. Okay. You have downloaded from the HST location, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so these are processed because there are many things which go into it, which they have mostly done most of the things and given it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So that's a science image finally. After pre-processing, they give it. From my observatory, then you have all the details of what is the seeing on that day, what is the sky, what is, various things, parameters of the telescope. All those things you do, and you have flats which we have you have to make while you're observing and other things. So all this has been done, and pre-processing has been done. Otherwise there'll be totally unyieldy images. So they go through a pipeline, and there are images which you can start working with mostly.
So those informations will not be there in the header file, sir?
Some information will be there in the header file. You read the header files, and it does give you some information, right? You just read the imhead for that slice. you will get the header information.
And the WHT file, one of the frame out of the four frames we have, is that that normal frame, sir? Flat.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Okay. We'll just discuss that later. Okay. Now I think it's beyond an hour.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. So we'll stop now, and I will write to you. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, then we'll meet. When shall we meet? We'll discuss on the maybe Wednesday we can meet. Tentatively, we'll fix it on Wednesday. And if you need more time, then we can meet next Saturday. Okay.
Sir, would it be possible for you to share the link for the past three classes, like the recordings?
Okay, fine. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.